Welcome to Sai Study Circle. Today we are discussing underwriting, which is for 14 marks. And this question is appeared in the year 2016 for 70 marks as well as for 100 marks. See, in this question, how to solve this question? See, why this is asked for 14 marks? What is there in this question? If we analyze, read the question carefully, we can easily give the answer for this. Now, let us read out the question. Here, A Limited issued 1 lakh equity shares of 100 each to M, N, O and P. See, there are 4 underwriters are there, M, N, O, P. These people have taken completely 1 lakh shares for their responsibility. And these people have taken as 30%, 30%, 20% and 20%. So 1 lakh is divided into 30, 30, 20, 20 to M, N, O, P. And in consideration of 4% commission. That means whatever the shares which they have undertaken to sell, on that they will pay, they will be paid 4% commission. That I will show you in the next step. And they also applied for firm underwriting, that is firm shares, as follows. That means MNOP, they have committed to buy for themselves about 3000 shares, 2000 shares, 2000 shares and 3000 shares. That means out of their proportion underwriting, whatever they want to sell, from that they themselves are buying so much. Apart from this, besides this, means excluding this firm underwriting, excluding this firm underwriting, the company is received totally 60,000 applications from the public. In this 60,000 applications, there are two things are included. One is marked applications and also unmarked applications. See, in this 60, marked is M, N, O, P has sold 10,000, 6,000, 8,000, 16,000. That means all put together, 16 plus 8 is 22, 24 plus 6 is 30, 30 plus 10 is 40. 40,000 underwriters have sold. The remaining 20,000, because the company received 60,000 applications, in that marked is 40, then how many unmarked is there? 20 unmarked applications are there. Now I'll read out the question completely. Show the number of shares to be taken by each underwriter, assuming the firm applications and as marked as well as unmarked. Now there are two questions in this. The firm applications, we have to take it as a marked applications, and firm applications as a unmarked also. Now let me show you first a statement of net liability of underwriters. Okay, now we are showing firm underwriting as marked. Firm as marked. This is the first question which we will going to answer. Now, in this, since there are 4 underwriters are there, I am taking 4 people's details. Now, this is M, N, O and P. What is the gross liability is? See, it is 30%, 30%, 20%, 20%. The ratio is very simple, 3:3:2:2. Now, 30% of 1 lakh is 30,000, 30% of 1 lakh is 30,000, 20% of 1 lakh is 20,000, again 20% is 20,000. Now, what is the first step for us is, we have to deduct unmarked applications. We don't know unmarked applications. Now, let us calculate calculation of unmarked applications. See, total applications received from the public is 60,000. In this, marked applications are 10, 6, 8, 16. Put together, you get 40,000. This 40,000 has to be minus from the total. This is what we call it as unmarked applications. These unmarked applications have to be deducted from MNOP.
Now, I will show you how to do this. 20,000 into 3 by 10, 3 by 10, 2 by 10 and 2 by 10. 3 2s are 6,000, again 6,000, 2 2s are 4,000 and 4,000. Okay, fine. Now, we get 24k, 24,000, 16,000 and 16,000. See, whenever he is given firm underwriting, what we have to do, first step is we have to minus unmarked. What is the second step? The very second step is we need to do that firm underwriting. This is a very important step. Please make a note. Firm underwriting, we have to do that. How many firm underwriting? M has did 3000, N has taken 2000, O has taken 2000 and P has taken 3000. Now, if you do that, you get 19,000, 22,000, 14,000 and 13,000. Now, if you just, we are minus, that's all. So, first step is unmarked applications. See, 24 minus 2, 22. 24 minus 3 is 21, I'm sorry. 16 minus 2 is 14. 16 minus 3 is 13. Okay. Now, we need to deduct marked applications. See, marked applications, he is given in the question. Marked and firm, both are given in the question. Unmarked, he was not given. We have calculated, we have distributed. Now, marked applications is, M has taken 10,000 sold, N is sold 6,000, and O is sold 8,000, and P is sold 16,000. Now, if you check it here, Mr. P has sold 16,000 shares. Mr. P has sold 16,000 shares. Okay, check in this first. So, now after deducting marked applications, see what are the marked applications, how many applications have sold by M, N, O, P is 10,000, 6,000, 8,000 and 16,000. If you closely observe, M is 10,000 subscribed, I mean marked applications, N is 26,000, O is 8,000 and P is 16,000. See, P is sold 3,000 extra, that means excess. When he sold excess, we have to put it as a minus or in the brackets. Now, what is the balance of 6,000? This is 16,000 and this is 11,000. Now, what is the next step for us? First, unmarked, firm and marked applications. Next is, look at here, the excess has to be distributed to, P's excess should be distributed to M, N, O. So, now, excess of P to M, N, O in the ratio of 3, 3, 2. Now, 3000 into 3 by 8, 3 by 8, 2 by 8. So, how much we get is 1125 and 750. So, now 1125 is 2250 plus 750 is 3000. So, now this becomes 0. Now, how much we get it here is 9 minus 1 is 8, 9. This is 875, 5 minus 1, 4, 14, and this is 5,250, and this becomes nil. So, this is what we call it as net liability of underwriters. To this, the last step is we have to add firm underwriting. You may ask a question, sir, already we have deducted firm underwriting here. Why we need to add? See, this is the net liability. Leaving firm underwriting, the underwriters have to sell so many number of shares. If we include firm underwriting also, definitely it will be more. Because their firm underwriting is 3000, 2000, 2000 and 3000. So, in total, this becomes 12,875, 16,875. 7250 and 3000. This will be the total liability of the underwriters. All of you understood? Thank you. Hello. Hello. We have come to the question number 1 for 14 marks. The question what we have done is when form applications we treated as a marked. Now we'll prepare a statement showing that when the form underwriting is shown as a unmarked. How to do that? See, we'll keep till here we'll keep the same. Okay, till the gross liability we'll keep it as it is. Now I'm writing, instead of marked, I'll write it as unmarked. Okay. Now how to find out that? Now if you take form application as a unmarked, when you treat form applications as a unmarked, what is to be done? See, first check with the total form underwriting taken up by the four underwriters. See, the form underwriting taken by MNOP is 3000, 2000, 2000, 3000, 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 5, 10,000. This 10,000 form applications, just add it here. We have to add it here, 10,000. Now, we are getting 30,000 as a unmarked applications. Now, we are treating form underwriting as a unmarked. That means when you are deducting unmarked applications, we should deduct 30,000, because actually unmarked is 20,000 only. Since we are treating form underwriting as a unmarked, we are adding form underwriting to this unmarked. Now the unmarked becomes 30,000. This you distribute it 3 by 10, 3 by 10, 2 by 10 and 2 by 10. Fine. Now how much you get? You have 9,000, 9,000, 6,000 and 6,000. Now just check the total. 21, 21, 14,000 and 14,000. See, in the last method, first step was unmarked, second step was form underwriting. Now since form underwriting we are treated as a unmarked, there is no need to deduct form underwriting separately, because already we have included in this. So deduct marked applications. Marked applications is 10,000, 6,000, 8,000 and 16,000. Now here if you check with the P, he has subscribed excess of 2,000 shares. Here no excess. Here 15,000, no excess. Here it is 11,000, no excess. Now the excess of P has to be distributed to MNO in the ratio of 3:3:2. So excess of P to MNO, how many are there? 2,000, 3 by 8, 3 by 8, 2 by 8. How we got 8? 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 2 is 8. Right, when you divide this in proportion, we get 750, 750 and 500. This is plus 2000 minus 2000 becomes nil. This is 5500, this is 14250, this is 10250. This we can call it as net liability. Right, after getting the net liability, what we need to do is we have to add firm underwriting in order to know the total liability of the underwriters. See, this is the net liability of the underwriter. If you add up firm underwriting, we will get the total underwriting, means total liability of the underwriters. What is a firm underwriting? Yeah, is 3,000, 2,000, 2,000 and 3,000. So now we get 13,250, 16,250, 7,500 and 3,000. This is called total liability. Guys, I have a small clue for you, whether we have done the correct answer or not. How to get it? Very simple. If you check this total, if you take the total of this, you should get 40,000. this 40,000 to match with what amount, what number? See, the total shares issued is 1 lakh and total applications received from the public is 60,000. So 1 lakh minus 60,000. 1 lakh minus 60,000. How much you get? You should get 40,000. So the difference of total issue and total received from the application from the public, that has to tie with the total liability. Then only we will get the correct answer. All of you got it? Now let us see how to calculate commission, because commission part is left out. Now we have seen finding out the total liability of the underwriters when the firm underwriting as marked, firm underwriting as a unmarked. Both we have seen. Both we have to do it for 14 months. Okay. Now we'll check with the commission. The commission part is very simple to calculate. I will show you. See, commission. Check with the, what is the total gross liability is 30, 30, 20, 20, right? So what is the, each share value is 100 rupees. Am I right? So multiply this with 100, 100, 100, 100. I will tell you how much you get. There is no need of calculators for this. Check with 4 zeros and 2 zeros, 5 zeros. 3 ones are 3. Okay. 4 zeros, 2 zeros, 6 zeros. So 6 zeros. So you get 30 lakhs. 6 zeros. Here also 30 lakhs. Here 20 lakhs. Here 20 lakhs. Got it? Now what is the commission? 4% commission. 4% on 30 lakhs. See, when you take 4%, 4 by 100, right? Cancel 2 zeros here. 2 zeros, 2 zeros, 2 zeros, 2 zeros. 4 threes are 12. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. That is 1,20,000 rupees. Same as it is for N. Now here, 4 twos are 8. That is 80,000. Because 4 zeros, 4 zeros, here also 80,000. So this is the amount of commission which we have calculated. See, commission calculation is as simple as it is. You can extend the statement, show the commission part there itself. See, my dear students, if you like my video and if you want more and more videos to upload, please duly subscribe my channel, Sai Study Circle. Don't forget it, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay, thank you. Hello everyone. Today's topic is underwriting. As you know that already, I have given one video for 14 marks question, which was asked in the year 2016. It may repeat again, but now we will going to solve one more question, which was asked in the year 2015. This is also 14 marks question. And a damn sure definite question. Without this question for 14 marks, there will be no question paper at all. Okay, let us know how to solve this question. So before reading the question or before going to the solution, everyone will have to read the question properly, carefully, so that we can make a proper note on it. See, the question is, Raj Limited invited applications to the public for 2,50,000 shares of rupees 10 each. Entire issue was undertaken by four people, four underwriters ABCD, to the extent of 30%, 20%, 30% and 20%, with the provision of firm underwriting. This is very important, with the provision of firm underwriting. That means what? ABCD has committed to buy 7,500 A, 2,500 by B, 500 by C and 2,500 shares of D. These are the shares purchased by the underwriters themselves. Now, what is given is the company received applications for 1,75,000, excluding firm underwriting. This is a very important word. Excluding means in this 1,75,000, firm underwriting is not included. All of you got it? Firm underwriting is not included. Then what are the things which are included in this 1,75,000? Is very simple. Marked applications as well as unmarked applications. See, definitely in this 1,75,000, marked and unmarked is will be included. If it is included, we have to check with how many marked applications are included. See, marked applications by A, B, C, D is clearly given 47,500, 52,500, 25,000 and 20,000. If you check the total, you get 1,40,000. See, 47,500, 7,500, 2,500 is 10,000, 10 plus 40, 50, 50 plus 50 is 1 lakh, 1 lakh plus 45 is 1,45,000. Now, what is the first calculation part for us is where to calculate unmarked applications. Now, calculation of unmarked applications. Total applications is 1,75,000. From this, if you minus marked, it comes to 1,45,000. You will get 30,000 as unmarked applications. This is very important for us because first step in calculation or preparation of knowing the net liability or total liability is unmarked applications. Now, what is the question is asking? Find out the net liability of the underwriters treating the firm underwriting as a marked, firm underwriting as an unmarked. Here there are two questions. Question number one, question number two. We need to prepare two statements. Now, let us start with calculating the total liability when the firm underwriting is treated as marked. Now, statement of total liability of underwriters. When firm underwriting is treated as marked. What is this? Marked applications. I will show you the difference. 2, 4. This is A, B, C and D. Now this is the particular for us. Okay. Now what is the first thing we have to take? We have to take the gross liability. Gross liability of underwriters is clearly given 30, 20, 30, 20. Total is 2,50,000. 2,50,000 into 30% is how much? 25,3 are 75,000. 2,50,000 into 20% is 50,000. 75,000, 50,000. Same as it is. Now, what is our next work is unmarked. We have to minus unmarked applications. Unmarked, how many applications we have? 30,000. What is the ratio? 3:2, 2:2, 3:2. That means 3 by 10, 2 by 10, 3 by 10, 2 by 10. Now, very simple. 3 by 10, 2 by 10, 3 by 10, 2 by 10. 3 threes are 9,000. 3 twos are 6,000. Same as it is, 9,000, 6,000. Now, the difference is 15 minus 9 is 66,000. 44,000. Same as it is, 66,000 and 44,000. First step. Second step is very important, guys. We need to deduct firm underwriting. Because when we are treating firm underwriting as a marked, how you deduct marked in the next step? Similarly, we have to deduct firm underwriting also. But it should be before marked. Okay, firm underwriting. See, firm underwriting is 7,500, 2,500, 500 and 2,500. Let's check with the totals. Calculation should be very good. Perfect. See, 10 minus 5, 15 minus 7 is 8 and 58,500. 501 and 41,500. 65,500. 500. 41,500. Now, we need to deduct marked applications. Okay. Clearly given marked applications made by A, B, C, D is given. A is 47,500. B has sold 52,500. C has sold 25,000. And D has sold 20,000. Now guys, if you closely observe, B has sold greater than Mr. anybody else. How many he has sold excess is? Very simple. 2 minus 1 is 1 and 11,000. So 11,000 he has sold more. Now, this excess we have to distribute it to A, C, D. Now, let us find out the difference here. 11,000 500, 0 and 4500. This is 21,500. Now, the next step is the excess of B to be distributed to ACD. So, 11,000 into 3 by 8, 3 by 8, 2 by 8. Okay. Because 3 by 8, 3 by 8, 2 by 8, how it is 3, 3, 2. Because we are distributing excess of B to ACD. Therefore, we should not consider base portion. Now, how much we get 11,000 into this thing is very simple. 4,125 and 2,750. Okay. Now, let us see. This is plus 11,000. Now, this becomes nil. Here, we need to deduct it. 5, 7, 8 minus 1 is 9 minus 1 is 8, 10 minus is 6875. Now here 5, 9, 7, 4, 3 and 6 and 36, 375. And here 5, 7, 8, 18,750. This is the net liability. This is what? Net liability. Actually, question in the question is asked only net liability. But we are going one step ahead in calculating the total liability, because in the next examination you may give the same question, but the question may be asked to find out the total liability, but in this question is asked only net liability. So what is to be done to calculate is very simple. Add back the firm underwriting. Add back the firm underwriting. See, before firm underwriting, A, B, C, D has net liability of this much. When you add back firm underwriting, their commitment, it becomes more. How much it becomes more is 7,500, 2,500, 500 and again 2,500. Now, we have to add it back. So, 14,375, this is 2,500, this is 36,875. And this is 21,250. Okay. Now, this is called as a total liability. See, always we have a cross check with, I shared the, clue for you in the first video also. When you check this total, it should be 1 lakh, 75,000. How it is? See, total applications received is 2 lakh 40. Total issue is 2 lakh 50. And total applications received is 1 lakh 75. The answer should be 75. See, if you check the total of all these three, we get 75,000. That means our answer is correct. So now, what is to be done? What is the next question for us? I hope you all of you understood. I hope all of you understood. Now, we have given an answer only for the part of the question, because he is asking us to prepare a statement of net liability treating firm underwriting as a mod. We have treated as a firm underwriting as a mod. But he is asking one more question. What happens if firm underwriting treated as a unmarked? So, for that, we have to show it in a little, you know, different, little different calculation. We'll try to find out. I will rub, okay? I hope all of you are, you know, following me. I will rub this. Let's check with this. See, I am living everything as it is. Only thing is, I am changing the little question little different, because he is asking treat firm underwriting as a unmarked now. Unmarked. See, when you are treating firm underwriting as a unmarked, already we have calculated unmarked as 30,000. Am I right? So what we have did in the previous this thing is, we have deducted firm underwriting separately, unmarked separately, firm underwriting separately. Now what we will going to do here, we did that, we add back the firm underwriting to this, that is 13,000. How it is? 7,500, 2,500, 10,000, 10,500 and 13,000. So now total unmarked applications has become 43,000. Total unmarked applications become how much? 43,000. Now 43,000 is to be distributed to ABCD in the ratio of 3/10, 2/10, 3/10, 2/10. Now let us see how to solve this. This is simple than the first this thing. Okay. So now the total 43,000 has to be distributed in this ratio. It comes to 12,900, and this also 12,900. Now 43 into 2/10 will be 8,600. Again 8,600. Now we will check the totals. 100, 14 minus 4 minus 2 is 2, 7 minus 1 is 6. This is also same 62,100. This is 400, 9 minus 8 is 1, and 41,400. Guys, Furman writing is to be the second step, but already we have included the Furman writing to the unmarked. Therefore, our next step is we have to minus marked applications. See, marked applications, A is sold by 47,500, this is 52,500, this is 25,000, this is 20,000. Am I right? See, there is no need of deducting the format rating, because we are treating format rating as a unmarked. Unmarked already we have included in this. Now, what is the total we get? Is 11 minus 7 is 4, 5 minus 4 is 1. Now here B has sold excess. 5 minus 4 is how much? 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. 5 minus 4 is 1. That is 11,100 is the excess sold by Mr. B. Now here total will be 7, 5 minus 2 is 37. 401 and 21,400. Now B has sold excess. The excess of B should be distributed to ACD. In which ratio B has to be get cancelled? A, B, A, C, D, 3, 3, 2 is 8. Now, excess of B to A, C, D. Okay. In what ratio? 3 is to 2. 11,100 into 3/8 and 2/8. Now, this is a plus 1100. This becomes nil now. Now, how to divide this? We get 4,162, because once if we calculate 3/8 once, for A and C it is the same proportion, and for D is 2776. Actually you get 775, you can make it as 7076, because if you add these 1, 2, 3, 4 items, 3 items, you should get 11,100. That's how it becomes nil. Now, let us find out what is the net liability of the underwriter. Net liability is 8, 3, 4. So, adding with that, right? I'm sorry. 6, 7, 18. 18,000. Is it adding? No. No. 8, 3, 4, 0. 10,438. Here it is 8, 3. 10 minus 1 is 9. 6 minus 4 is 2, 32, and this is 4, 2, 13 and 6, 8 and 8. This is the net liability of the underwriter. To this, what is to be added is Furman rating. Already Furman rating, we know 7,500, 2,500, 500, again 2,500. Now, we got, adding it back, 2,500. 33,438 and 11,24 and 11 and 21,000, 124. This is the total liability. You may ask a question, sir, why again we have to add back in the format rating? See, both, when you treat format rating marked and unmarked, the compulsory we need to add and format rating. Why? Yake? It's very simple. When you get net liability, what is the meaning of net liability? The underwriters which yet to sell, yet to subscribe. If they cannot subscribe, they only have to buy. See, this is the amount of number of shares. Apart from this, these underwriters have committed to buy themselves. Right? If we add back to the unsubscribed, we get the total. All of you got it? So, this is the solution for the question paper 2015. My dear guys, I'm telling you, you may be asked a similar type of question or the same type of question or same question sometimes. Please subscribe my channel,
Sai Study Circle, and please comment which chapter you need a video. Definitely I will going to help you out. And don't forget to press the bell icon, and don't forget to share your friends. Thank you.